Hi, this is Electronics. In this video I will try to connect the PAM8403 to the XYBT mini Bluetooth receiver module and to do some troubleshootings. But before the video starts, be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload a new video. You can find a review video of the boards in the video description. Be sure to check those out before building this circuit. As you can see, the PAM8403 is already placed on the breadboard. The speaker is also connected directly to the board without any kind of filter. The oscilloscope is also connected to the output to see the outgoing signal. Now I make an upper angle shot. You can see the XYBT mini and the PAM8403 boards. Everything is set up. The first thing I place is a 4.7 microfarad capacitor at the input of PAM8403, which will block the DC output of XYBT mini. With the gray wire, I connect the signal ground between the two boards. This is the schematic of the circuit in its current state. I power up the board and, as you can hear, a lot of noise is generated. The oscilloscope is also showing this. We start from here and the aim is to have a clean sound with these two boards combined together. The human hearing range is between 20 Hz and 18 kHz. This means the sound which is lower or higher in frequency than the before mentioned range can be eliminated in order to achieve a better sound quality. Eliminating high frequency noises like the 2.4 GHz from the Bluetooth receiver, the 260 kHz from the PAM switching frequency and also the 60 kHz switching frequency of the power supply can greatly improve sound quality. Next up, I connect a coil in series with the output of the PAM. After that, a 2.2 microfarad electrolytic capacitor parallel to the output. These two components form a passive low-pass filter which filters out high-frequency noises. A 2200 microfarad capacitor is placed on the power supply lines near to the XYBT receiver module. I demonstrate the difference with the capacitor connected. As you see now, the signal on the oscilloscope is more similar to a clean audio signal, but still with a lot of small noises. The low frequency sounds are distorted, these are usually caused by the ground loop. Later in this video, I will explain and present a solution to the ground loop. In the next step, I've placed a 22k ohm resistor parallel to the input of the PAM, which forms a high pass filter with the 4.7 microfarad capacitor, but it didn't help at all. After that, I place a 100 ohm resistor in series and a 47 nanofarad monolithic capacitor in parallel with the input of the PAM. These two components also form a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of around 33 kHz. This is how the schematic looks so far, including all the modifications and filters. After a rearrangement of the wires on the breadboard by creating a star-shaped grounding, the results were really promising, as you can hear. The low frequency sounds are still a little bit distorted, but the result is a lot better compared to the beginning. Finally, here is the top view of the circuit. This is the final working version. It can be noticed how almost all ground connections end up at this point. This is one of the reasons why the circuit is working better than the first version. Now let's talk about the ground loop. Ground loop appears when two or more electrical equipments are connected together, which results multiple paths to the ground, so a loop is created. This ground loop acts like an antenna and can emit electromagnetic interference. The first solution that comes into the mind is to separate the ground for each equipment, but these must be referenced to the same ground, otherwise a so-called floating ground appears and they would not work properly. A real possible solution is the star ground connection, or also known as star grounding or star point. To create a star grounding, all the ground connections from every device must be connected in a single point. Before the video ends, I would like to give some more troubleshooting tips. First, using line transformer or lithium-ion battery instead of SMPS. Using battery as power supply can really reduce or eliminate the noise and hum. Second, input capacitor is not needed for the PAM8403, it has already a 1.2 microfarad capacitor on the circuit board. This is not an improvement, but it is not a necessary component, so to save space it can be left out. Third, use metal film resistors and audio capacitors in the circuit. These components have low noise, therefore they are good for audio circuits. Fourth, keep the leads short, these long wires that are used in the video can easily pick up high frequency noises. Making the lines short, especially the ground, can really improve the sound quality. Fifth, you can buy already made Bluetooth receiver modules with Class D amplifiers built together like the DWCT14+. You can see a review video of this board on the link in the description. The best solution is a trial and error, try components, filters, and if it improves sound quality, then you leave it in the circuit. Thank you for watching, leave a like if you want more videos like this.